Hello everyone, I am Pitambar Gadve. As we know, there are three modes of heat transfer: conduction, convection and radiation. In previous videos, we studied conduction mode of heat transfer. Now, in this video, we will discuss about convection. So, let us discuss fundamental concept of convection. As we know, the energy transfer from solid surface to surrounding fluid or from surrounding fluid to solid surface when fluid is in a motion is called as heat transfer by convection. That is, transfer of energy from solid surface to surrounding fluid or from surrounding fluid to solid surface when fluid surrounding fluid which is in a motion, and when fluid is motionless, then heat transfer there is by conduction or by pure conduction. So we can say when fluid is motionless, heat transfer is by pure conduction. Heat transfer is by pure conduction. Or we can say, higher the motion of a fluid, then rate of heat transfer is also higher. So higher the rate of heat transfer, or to obtain higher rate of heat transfer, the fluid motion should be higher. Higher the fluid motion, rate of heat transfer is also higher. Rate of heat transfer is also higher. There is some similarities between conduction and convection. These are similar, as it requires conduction as well as convection also requires some material medium to transfer. We know in case of conduction, heat is transferred through the solid, so there is a solid medium. And in case of convection, we have a material medium, that is solid surface is necessary as well as surrounding fluid which is in motion is necessary. So there is a material medium required to transfer heat transfer by convection or conduction. Now there is a difference between these conduction and convection also. So there is difference is, in convection we require fluid motion. So to understand the mechanism of convection, let us consider two plates which are parallel to each other. One, suppose this is a hot plate and this is cold plate. Two parallel plates, one is hot and another is cold plate, and there is a fluid between these two. Let us consider this is a fluid between these two, and we know the heat transfer by conduction between these two takes place when the fluid is still. If the fluid is motionless, and when fluid is motionless, the heat transfer from hot plate to cold plate takes place by conduction. And we know how this conduction takes place. So when the fluid molecules comes in contact, let us consider this is one molecule which comes in contact with the hot plate. So when it comes in contact with the hot plate, it attains the temperature of a hot plate, and it transfer energy to the surrounding molecule. Transfer energy by conduction to the surrounding molecule, and then this molecule again transfer energy to the surrounding molecule, and so on until it reaches to the cold plate. So by this mechanism heat transfer by conduction takes place. Now let us consider a heat transfer between these two plates by convection. So to happen heat transfer by convection, we require a fluid motion. Suppose this fluid is in motion, or to create motion, let us consider a syringe, and we pick up some droplets from here At this point, we pick up some droplet in a syringe and let us inject that droplet by using syringe to at this point. So pick up some droplet by using syringe and inject the droplets, inject that droplets here. So because we pick up these droplets near to the hot plate, near to the hot surface, and injected near to the cold surface, it will transfer heat quickly to the surrounding fluid, surrounding molecules, and heat transfer quickly takes place, reaches to the cold plate. That means in case of convection, due to motion of a fluid, the molecules are moving very quickly, so rate of heat transfer is more in case of convection as compared to conduction heat transfer. So this is how convection heat transfer is takes place. So convection heat transfer depends on various parameter, or we can say this heat transfer by convection is complex phenomenon because it depends upon various parameters, like density of a fluid, viscosity of a fluid, specific heat of a fluid, also velocity of a fluid. It depends on a fluid properties as well as also it depends upon geometry of a solid surface. Though, because it depends on number of parameters, this phenomenon is complex, but to calculate rate of heat transfer by using this is given by a very simple statement. So we can say rate of heat transfer is directly proportional to temperature difference between solid surface and fluid, between surface and fluid, and this is given by Newton's law of cooling. We call it this as a Newton's law of cooling. So we can write Q is directly proportional to temperature difference, or we can write Q per unit area is equal to H into delta T, where H is heat transfer coefficient and its unit is watt per meter square Kelvin, and this term having unit watt per meter square, which is called as heat flux. So rate of heat transfer by convection is calculated. Q is equal to H A delta T. A is surface area, meter square. H is heat transfer coefficient in watt per meter square Kelvin. Delta T is temperature difference in degree Celsius or in Kelvin. This is known as Newton's law of cooling. Now let us consider this convection is classified into two groups. So we can classify this convection depends on the motion of a fluid. We can classify this convection into two groups. One is called as natural convection, or another is called as forced convection. So this natural convection is also called as free convection. Natural convection means when fluid is flowing due to density difference or due to buoyancy force. If fluid is flowing naturally, then it is called as natural convection. Whereas in case of forced convection, there is some external source is used to create the motion of a fluid. So this is called as forced convection. In forced convection, we use some external source. So let us understand this natural and forced convection by some examples. So we can say natural convection is also called as free convection, because it is fluid is flowing naturally, so we can also call it as a free convection. So let us understand this by some example. Let us consider there is a plate. Suppose there is a plate, hot plate, and we have to cool this hot plate. okay, there is a hot plate and we have to cool this hot plate. So by using here, we have to cool this plate. This is plate, hot plate, hot plate. How natural convection is occurs? So let us consider, this is a one molecule comes in contact with the surface of a hot plate. As it comes in contact with the hot plate, it becomes hot, its density goes on decreasing, means it becomes light, and it moves in upward direction. So once again I repeat, when the molecule of a air, colder molecule of air, comes in contact with the hot plate, heat exchange takes place and it becomes warmer, and due to density, it lower density, it moves in a upward direction. So we can say warmer air, warmer air rises, and this is how natural convection heat transfer is takes place. Let us understand natural convection again. So let us consider, there is an egg is kept on a table, hot egg. Suppose this is a hot egg. Okay, this is hot egg. So cooling of a hot egg is also kept on this. So when the fluid comes in contact, air comes in contact with the hot egg, its temperature increases. As temperature increases, density decreases, and it moves in a upward direction. So the flow is like this. So this is also example of a natural convection. Natural convection heat transfer. There is no any external source is used. Now let us discuss a forced convection. So in case of forced convection, we use some external source. So let us consider same example. Suppose there is a plate. Let us consider some example. There is a plate. Okay, there is a plate, hot plate, and we have to cool this hot plate. And if we use fan to cool this hot plate, so due to fan, the motion is increased, and this type of heat transfer is called as heat transfer by convection or heat transfer by forced convection, because some external source in the electrical energy is used to transfer the heat. Here also we can say similar example. When we apply fan here, so due to fan, velocity of a fluid increases, and as velocity of a fluid increases, rate of heat transfer is also increases. We can say heat transfer in a forced convection is more than that of natural convection or free convection, because in forced convection velocity is more due to some external sources used. For example, let us consider a cup of hot coffee kept on a table. So when cup of hot coffee is kept on a table, the heat exchange between hot coffee and surrounding air is by convection, that is by natural convection. And when we pick up that cup of hot coffee and blow on the coffee, then that heat exchange between air and hot coffee is due to forced convection. That means externally we are blowing the air, some external source is used, so that is called as forced convection. So this is all about a fundamental concept of natural and forced convection. In next lecture, we will discuss more detail about natural convection. Thank you.